Hello, today we are on the Norwegian Getaway and we are gonna do a full ship tour. As I always do my ship tours, I start them here in the lobby or the atrium on deck 6. So we're gonna start from the bottom of the ship and work our way up. So deck 4 is the tender lobby. It's the only time you go on deck 4. Deck 5 is all staterooms. So we're starting here on deck 6. Okay, so the heart of the atrium is right here. It's gonna be a large banquette of seating around a two-story screen. This is where a lot of events happen throughout the day. They're all in the daily planner and there's always something going on here. It's very early in the morning, that's why there's nothing going on right now. So here's the atrium bar and it's got a nice central location, seating all the way around. On the far side is Starbucks and we'll walk that way in just a second. But also here is our guest services desk. The cruise consultant, this is where you get your cruise next certificates for Norwegian, and of course the shore excursions desk. There are also these touch screens all around the ship, and you see above it, it says shore excursions and show reservations, so you can make a lot of your choices here with the touch screen without having to wait in line. Next to the atrium bar is Starbucks. And yes, Starbucks will take Starbucks gift cards if you have them. And then coming around, this is the internet cafe. So there are computers here, or you can get Wi-Fi for your phones or tablets. They have photographers all around the ship, but if you want to do a special photo session, you can schedule that here as well. So you've got the meeting rooms over here if you're here for an event. These are smaller meeting rooms. And then the library. So in the library, there are games, there are books. It's a nice quiet area. Okay, so on deck 6 forward is the Cirque Illusionarium. This is a specialty dining / show. And the name of the show that is held in here is Cirque Dreams and Steam. And then they also hold the Wine Lovers, the musical, in this auditorium. Okay, so from the atrium bar, you go down the hall this way. Look up, and you can see the big chandelier, and you can see that this is the heart of decks 6, 7, and 8. So to the right is Headliners. To the left is Le Bistro. Le Bistro is the French dining restaurant. So here they have, as they call it, al fresco dining on the outside, and then the more intimate dining inside. So this is currently set up for an event in this main area, but you can see how the tables are set. This is probably the most romantic restaurant if you're looking for a special evening. Okay, just past Le Bistro is Teppanyaki. So Teppanyaki is the Japanese hibachi. This was hands down our favorite meal of the cruise. So there's lots of hibachis. So you'll see that there's two here, two in the back. And then more over here. And then you go around the corner and more over here. Okay, all down the center is always art hanging. They have some pulled down right now because they are doing an art auction, but you will see all the art hanging through this gallery. And then we are coming to Mix Bar here in the center. And Mix Bar is open when these restaurants are open. So right now, Nick's Bar is closed because it's early in the morning. But you have Taste on one side and Savor on the other. These are two of the main dining rooms. They are both serving brunch at the moment. Okay, so past Taste and Savor is the elevator. So there are elevators forward and aft, none midship, which is typical of this class of ship. But there are lots of elevators forward and aft. So when you get by the elevator, you will see a board that tells you where you are on the ship, and then also where everything is located on the ship by deck. And then past the elevators are the stairs. And on deck 6, 7, and 8, you will always find restrooms back here as well. Okay, so starting on deck 7 aft is the largest of the main dining rooms, which is the Tropicana room. This is only open at night. So you can see this is a very large dining room area in here. It goes all the way around. The coolest thing about this dining room is the stage and dance floor, because on certain evenings they'll have live music to go with your dinner, and also the dancers from Burn the Floor. Okay, so past the aft elevators on deck 7, we are coming to the casino area. So if you look to your left, there's Bar 21, which is the casino bar. And yes, there are slot machines that you can play as you drink. And then to the right is Shanghai Noodle Bar. This is open for lunch and it is complimentary. Also in the casino area, you will find Bliss. This is the nightclub. Let's go take a look in here. So in here you do have a bar, dance floor, these walls light up, the ceiling is covered in light. So this is where you come for the party music. And then on this side of Bliss, it's a little bit more of a laid-back, quiet area. So they do have the curtain that separates the two. Okay, so we're gonna walk through the casino. You can see the size of this casino. It is a big casino. And then you come out of the casino into Ocean's. Ocean's Bar and Grill is the 24-hour place. You have a full bar over here, lots of high top tables. Food is served over here 24 hours a day. So you have electronic darts over here, a pool table, a few arcade games. And a bowling alley. Okay, deck 7 all the way forward is the getaway theater. We have the box office on one side, but the theater entrances are on both sides. So here's the box office. So once you come in, when you first get on board, if you haven't set up your theater reservations, you can come in here and make the theater reservations. It's on the right side of the theater. And you can see how large the theater is. There's not a bad seat in the house the way that the stadium seating is done. So there are two main shows in here, Burn the Floor and Million Dollar Quartet. They're each held for 2 nights, and the stage will completely take on their show. On deck 8 is the waterfront. And the waterfront goes almost all the way around the ship. Let's walk out there. So out here on the waterfront, there is outdoor seating for all of the restaurants on deck 8. Cagny's, La Cucina, Moderno, Ocean Blue, and then you'll see there's outdoor bars as well. The getaway has a Miami theme to it. So you'll see these walls painted and the vibrant colors and the landscape of Miami. So this is my favorite spot to come and just hang out on the ship. I absolutely love the view off the back, hearing the water being churned up. It's very peaceful back here, and it's usually has hardly anyone back here, so you can just come and relax and enjoy the views. Also very interesting back here are these windows. See, you can stand on these. And look straight down into the water if you're brave enough. Probably the most happening place on the waterfront is the Sid Norman's Poorhouse Outdoor Bar. It's early in the morning, but typically this bar is packed. And getting a seat at this bar stool is very lucky because you get this amazing view. You want to play a giant game of chess? Here you go. Okay, now we are inside on deck 8. So once you're past the elevators, you have La Cucina on your right. La Cucina is the Italian specialty dining restaurant. And then on your left is Sid Norman's Poorhouse. P-O-U-R, meaning poor beer. Because the soup of the day is beer. There is a live band in here almost every night. This is also where karaoke is. This is the most happening place on the ship that we have seen. It's always fun, it's always packed. So if you see something happening at Sid's, get there early so you can get a seat. Okay, right outside of Sid's is Sunset Bar. Which has a really nice, comfortable seating area. This is a very warm and inviting place on the ship to come and sit and relax. And then these doors lead out to Sid Norman's Poorhouse on the waterfront. So this is a really happening area. Then over here in the corner is the Humidor Cigar Lounge. Only cigars are allowed to be smoked in here, not cigarettes. And if you forgot to bring a cigar, don't worry. Okay, so coming into the center, there's a lot happening right here. So here is the Sky Vodka Ice Bar. This is an extra experience. So the bar is not just open for anyone to come in. You pay a $20 experience fee, which does cover two drinks, and you get to get all bundled up nice and warm and enter the ice bar for as long as you can stand it or until the time limit expires. Next to the ice bar is the Sugarcane Mojito Bar. You'll see a piano right here. There's almost always live music in the afternoons and evenings. And then coming around, we have the Raw Bar, where you can get oysters and other seafood items. Wasabi, which is a sushi bar. And in the center is Ocean Blue. So Ocean Blue is the fine dining seafood restaurant. And you will see it is very small. So it the reservations do fill up very, very quickly for this restaurant. Okay, so now we are entering into Trade Winds, which is the shopping area. So we have jewelry in the center. All along this side is jewelry and sunglasses. You have the beauty shop over here, which is perfumes, etc. And on this side is the Tides Boutique, which has a little bit of everything, some clothing, some souvenirs, etc. And then the photo gallery. So you come to the photo gallery to pick out any photos that were taken during the cruise. Okay, all the way aft on deck 8, past the bank of elevators, are Cagney's and Moderno. Cagney's is the steakhouse, and Moderno is the Brazilian steakhouse. So in the center is the Prime Meridian Bar. The Prime Meridian Bar services these two restaurants. So you have Cagney's on the right. And Cagney's runs through here behind Prime Meridian. You have a view down into the Tropicana dining room. So if there's dancing, music, and a show going on, you will be able to see it from up here. Okay, and on the left side is Moderno. So Moderno will have all of the appetizers and side dishes set up here in a buffet style. Then once you have your seat, they will start bringing out the meats. Decks 9 through 14 are all cabins, so we're going to skip up to deck 15 to see more of the ship, but be sure and check out our separate videos on the cabin tours. So on deck 15 forward is the entrance to the Haven. So if you're staying in the Haven, you're the only ones that can get in. See, it does say key card access only. And on the other side of deck 15 forward is the Mandara Spa and the Pulse Fitness Center. So one whole side is cardio, and the other side is all weights. And you do have locker rooms on each side for the men and the women, and then the entrance to the spa is here. Okay, so coming outside on deck 15, so there are 5 slides, 2 drop slides, 2 enclosed twisting slides, and this purple one is an open air twister slide. And these drop slides do extend over the edge of the ship. And then the kids splash zone. So none of the jets are going off right now, but there are sprayers everywhere out here, and I've seen the kids having an absolute blast. Okay, so I'm up on deck 16 now. So deck 16 is your sports and activities deck. You've got water slide exits up here. There's lots of splashing going on there. Rock climbing wall, video arcade. Let's go check out everything on this deck. Okay, so when you first walk up the stairs, you'll see this nice seating area. This is a really nice spot. You have the jogging track that's going all the way around. You have the rock climbing wall. Check this out. Hey, deck 16, you're gonna find Margaritaville. So Margaritaville in the morning serves breakfast just like on the buffet, but for lunch, it has its own special Margaritaville menu. We're at the aft elevators right now, and you'll see the video arcade. You'll see this is the entrance to Margaritaville, which is on our left. Entourage, which is the teen lounge, is back here. You'll see Spice H2O. And this is the second entrance to Margaritaville. So I'm catching Entourage empty right now. This is the teen area. It does have an entrance into the video arcade. But wow, the teens have a nice view, don't they? And their own private space here with their own dance club. All right, so we're gonna head out to Spice H2O. Because Spice H2O is an adults only area. So you'll see lots of sun loungers around here. There are two hot tubs back here. This area, which looks so relaxing and cool. And when it's not windy, there's a waterfall. It's a little windy today, so the waterfall's been turned off. Spice H2O does have its own bar over here, and this is one of the smoking sections on the ship. Okay, so right above Margaritaville is the staircase that'll lead you up to deck 17. We have the mini golf and the sports complex and the ropes course. And then look up and you're gonna see the ropes course. One of the coolest features of this ropes course is the plank. That's literally hanging off the side of the ship. Brave souls to do that. You'll see up top is the sports deck. So this up here is hours upon hours of entertainment for active kids, brave adults. Bouncy slide. Okay, and you climb this staircase and you'll get to see the basketball court. So this is super, super cool. It is a huge, full-size basketball court up at the very, very top of the ship. It's completely enclosed, so you're not gonna lose the balls. And they'll play other games up here like soccer, volleyball, dodgeball. I mean, this is a huge sports course. That's pretty cool. We're back down on deck 17 now. We were just up there with the ropes course on 18. And from here we get a better view of the drop slides. Okay, so up here on deck 17 is the Guppies, which is the under 3 playroom. So 6 months to 2 years old would come in here. And then this is the main entrance to the haven. See, a much prettier door than downstairs. And then this staircase right here will take you up to, there's another sun deck, and Vibe is above these stairs. Okay, so we are in Garden Cafe right now for breakfast. The Garden Cafe is at the back of deck 15 and runs all the way around the back of the ship.